用过探探 Tinder 也用过、
Yes, for a bit. And now I don't. Well, because the people I found are just want, you know, to just find hookups or like sex or stuff like that.
I do, yeah.
Yes, back home, but I haven't since I've been in Shanghai.
I already used Tinder last year.
追一个女生没追到，然后想要认识一点新的人，从正常男生的心里，当然约炮的成分也是有的。
I think especially for people my age, the kind of definition between like a hookup or a relationship kind of gets blurred.
Basically, to find friends and you know meet new people, because sometimes you just your surroundings are just boring.
Just use it for mostly talking.
通常来说，如果他信息量少的话，我是。不管它好看还是不好看，我都是会按叉叉的。但是如果它信息量大，然后兴趣方面跟我有类似的话，我会选勾勾。现在 P 图的人太多了，你永远都不知道外貌它到底是不是长这样的。
What determines whether I swipe left or right? I think it's completely arbitrary, half the time. Yeah.
Most of it is for looks, because you see the picture. So.
Well, of course, if they're good looking.But the bio really matters to me. They seem like they're like really clever, and that makes me more inclined to swipe right for sure.
Mostly age and the distance kilometers.
Definitely that toxic masculinity is a no-no.
They're just, some people don't take pictures of their like selves. Either they take pictures with their friends and you don't know who the actual person is, you know, you're like, which one of them all, you know? Or just, you know, they don't pick, they just take pictures of like the mountains or something and you're like, okay, who is that?
If she's like wearing like a lot of really like crazy makeup and the photo is really low quality,then that's just like, nah, for sure.
I guess wait for them to text you first. And no, I'm just leave it to the flow, I guess.
Wait the person to say something because I didn't know what to say.
有的时候人数太多了，我会先删掉几个，然后就开始发消息吧，发自己平时不敢跟别人发的。不管是性方面的话题，还是家庭方面的话题，或者是自己碰到一些难处，不会建立深厚的友谊，但是可以起到一个有的时候如果受伤的话，心理疗伤的作用。
Just something really funny. Maybe try to relate it back to her interests.
碰到过各种人，碰到过刚分手的，刚分手还对对方死缠烂打的，想离婚的，什么人都有。最糟的一个，加了微信之后开始死缠烂打。
Oh man, the first time, with this guy that I thought via Skype and via the internet we had a really good mutual connection, and so it was a really great start of a date, and we met in person, it was going really well, until he kissed me, and that's when I knew that physically it was a complete and utter turn off.Sort of like physical magnetism at that moment just died.
I just prefer, you know, to actually meet and know someone before, you know, he just says, you know, like, let's have random sex or something like that. So, yeah, I guess that's it.
I've met my boyfriend on Tinder. So we live next to each other. And then we went to a mall and went to the cinema to watch a movie. I was Captain America. And...
优点是它可以提供一个平台。
I feel like those kinds of dating apps kind of streamline the process, where it's like, okay, I'm consciously making the decision to start dating people in my life.
I think it's an opportunity to actually find someone you know you like and to date.
Advantages, of course, it opens you up to new people.
长相就是软件的长相，感觉不是会有点 low， 而是会有一种让你感觉。就这个软件它就是用来干坏事情的。
I guess maybe the spontaneity of day-to-day life kind of gets, gets maybe lost.
You know, some people are just too, not aggressive, like just too vulgar and, you know, want stuff from you that maybe you don't want to.
It kind of promotes, like, especially in America, there's a really big, like, hookup culture. And it kind of promotes that opposed to less, more really meaningful personal relationships.
I don't think it's the apps themselves that have changed the way we go, but rather that they're merely reflecting what we're looking for.
Yeah, I think so. That like before, just people, you know, used to just like meet and go out and, you know, have this friendship first. And now it's all just like, yeah, I like how you look. Let's just, you know.
A question of preference, I mean, some of my greatest relationships in the world have been through pure spontaneity. And I think for the current space that I'm in, I'm not necessarily keeping my eyes open for that kind of spontaneity to come into my life, just because I am so busy and so focused on other parts of my life. So I'd rather just utilize Tinder for the current moment I'm in.
现实当中认识朋友，跟自己最好的朋友是互相骂出来的关系，跟女朋友也是经历很多坎坷的事之后才走到这一步的。网上达不到，因为网上一开始就把自己的弱点暴露给对方的话，就等同于你没有一个渐进的过程。
Meeting people in person, definitely. Because everything can look different on pictures or on chat. It's different, you know, to see somebody in person. So.
No, I don't have. I think things just happen like this.